Good evening, everyone. It is so good to see this wonderful crowd. This is a great, great group. Of course, we have this two nights, and seeing this crowd for the first night, I'm really, really glad we went ahead and decided to do that. We had talked about consolidating it into one night, but if we have this many tomorrow night, we'd have been in big trouble if we had tried to do it in one night. So I'm glad you're here. And it really warms my heart that you're here, more so for this program than any other, because these pianists, these performers, are first of all local talent. They're all either staff members, faculty members, alumni, or current students, and you'll see all of the above. But they have been working since May on this program, and they're playing some very challenging music. Now, some of the music is what we, back in Ohio, where I came from, used to call long-haired music. You know what that is, right? But it'll be interspersed with some sacred music and some fun music, some patriotic music. You're going to enjoy it tonight. You've probably already looked at the program. Hopefully you received one when you came in the door. There's the regular concert series program, but there's also the insert that tells you all the information about the performers and so on. And there's just some exciting pieces on the program tonight. I can't wait to hear it. Briefly, I'm going to tell you what we have left in this concert series. Obviously, there's one more night of this particular performance, and that is tomorrow night at 7. Please tell your friends about this performance. When you go out of here being exhilarated for what you've heard, you get on the phone, you start texting, you get on your Facebook Messenger, and you tell all your friends, you need to go tomorrow night to the Piano Extravaganza, because it is amazing. And we'd love to fill the house again tomorrow night. So you're welcome to come back. I would love to see you come back as well. Also, and the final concert in the series this year is Brent Vernon and Vision Reunion. That is on Saturday, March 25. Brent Vernon is an internationally known singer, songwriter, ventriloquist, and children's author. He has traveled far and wide. His materials have been distributed far and wide. And he just has an incredible ministry, but to all ages, not just children. In fact, his music is oriented more toward an adult audience, but he also has a tremendous ministry toward children. And so I'm very excited about this program. Despite the fact that he is well known and widely traveled, he is from Hobe Sound. He is one of ours. He attended our school. He's a native. He goes to our church here when he's home. And we just love Brent. Now, when Brent was in college here, there were two young ladies that he started singing with in a trio. It actually was more than a trio initially, but it congealed down to a trio. And they traveled a few years on their own, independent of the college, and just had a beautiful ministry all over the country. And they are coming back to join him. So it will be Brent Vernon and Vision Reunion. Vision is the trio. Brent will do some of his own stuff. He'll have his buddy Sam, his ventriloquist figure, with him. And it's just going to be a great night. So don't miss it. Saturday, March 25. Let me also say something about our sponsors. Now, we are very, very grateful to have had for many years now Treasure Coast Sea Winds Funeral Home and Crematorium. And they combine with Forest Hills Memorial Park. Both of these are up in Stuart. They have multiple locations. Their contact information is in your program. They are our premier business sponsors, and they make this possible. And let's give them a great big round of applause, thanking them for their generosity. And I've said it before, but I'll say it again. Do your children, do your executor a favor, and make your arrangements in advance for end-of-life issues. Do it while you still have your thinking cap on, while you're still able, and do it with Treasure Coast Sea Winds and Forest Hills Memorial Park. Also, A1 Auto Care, we acknowledge them in these concerts because they have been so generous to Hobe Sound Ministries across the years. They maintain all of our fleet of vehicles for all three ministries. And by the way, we have three ministries here. We have the church. This is the sanctuary in which you're sitting. Two sanctuaries, the larger one where we have the singing Christmas tree, and this sanctuary where we meet the rest of the year. And then we also have the school. Of course, you're familiar with the school, Hobe Sound Bible College, Hobe Sound Christian Academy. And we have pre-kindergarten all the way through graduate classes now. And you can take classes online. You don't have to be a kid. You can be a silver-haired brainiac and say, I want to take... No, you don't even have to be a brainiac. You can take those online classes. But we also have FEA Ministries. They have mission works all over the world. And they just have some incredible things. Orphanages and colleges and just amazing things that they do. Not to mention all the many churches that they planted around the world. And so we're excited to partner with them. But back to what I was saying about our sponsors. I left for the airport at 2 a.m. this morning. If I'm wandering a little bit, you'll understand why, right? A1 Auto Care, Dave and Esther Morgan are here. And Dave, wave at us, won't you? That's them over there. Give them a great big round of applause. And it just so happens that their daughter, Marianne Morgan Mills, is the one who put all of this program together. You're going to hear her playing quite a bit, but really, this is her brainchild. She's the one who's put all this effort into it, and so we're very thankful. She's a brand new faculty member at Hobe Sound Bible College. This is her first time teaching, first year teaching in our music department, and she's a graduate. So we're very proud of her and very thankful for her hard work, and we will acknowledge her more later. One other quick thing that I want to mention. This is something a little unusual, but I'm going to mention it anyway. We have an alumnus. His name is Stephen Nix, and he is opening an indoor golf simulator in Stuart, and their grand opening is tomorrow. How many of you like to golf? Oh, quite a few of you. If you want to do a really neat indoor golf simulator, they have three bays, and they are at, I can't read the address here. Hang on, I'm going to have to enlarge it. But their grand opening is tomorrow. They're at 6130 Southeast Federal Highway in Stuart. And it's just going to be an exciting time tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. And they're going to be serving Jupiter donuts. How many of you have had Jupiter donuts? Oh, my goodness. I swore off of those in 2016, and that's why I can button this jacket tonight. But anyhow, introductory membership deals will be available, so check that out. We'd love to see you participate in that. Let me acknowledge a couple of groups who made reservations tonight. We always want to acknowledge our wonderful friends from First United Methodist Church of Hobe Sound. There they are, right there. Yes. And then Pastor Eddie Santiago is the pastor of our Spanish church that's just right across the driveway over here. And he also happens to be the chaplain out at Payson Park. That's the massive horse racing training facility just out west of town here. And he has a very large group here tonight. Where are the Payson Park people? Hey, there they are. So I'm so glad they're here, and thank you, Pastor Eddie, for bringing your crew. And I'm just excited about tonight, so I'm going to shut up. Oh, I'm going to get in trouble if I don't mention the bookstore. Literally, there are people in this crowd who will rush the stage and get me if I don't mention the bookstore. So right across the driveway over there is Hobe Sound Christian Bookstore. Don't forget, on your way out, avoid the car line, go over to the bookstore. Books, CDs, snacks. As Josh Modelman say, your Hobe Sound swag, you know, t-shirts and all that kind of stuff, coffee mugs. Stop over at the bookstore on your way out. Let's pray together, and then we will begin. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this privilege of enjoying this music that we're about to hear tonight. Thank you for the hard work that's gone into it. Thank you for the facilities that you've blessed us with, the people that you've blessed us with, so that we can put on a production like this with local talent, but with the highest of quality. And we're just praying that you would bless these instrumentalists tonight, that they would play for your glory. Lord, may we have our spirits lifted, may we be inspired, and most of all, may we worship the God of music. For all that you do, we'll praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
are. Let me applaud your cultural sophistication for coming to and enjoying a program such as this. Let me applaud your cultural sophistication for not clapping between movements. I went to the Kravis Center the other night, and people were clapping between movements, and finally somebody said, shh. But this is a highly sophisticated audience. There was no clapping between movements. We've heard from such a diverse array of composers this evening, everybody from Bach to Bernstein. Of course, you know, if you're truly musically sophisticated, you don't say Bach. You know, I Handel killed all of his chickens because all they did was going around saying Bach, Bach, Bach. No, if you're truly musically sophisticated, you say Bach. Say it with me. One, two, three, Bach. There you go. You are a highly sophisticated audience. I'm so proud of you. You know, great composers never die. They just decompose, right? Yes. Okay. Enough of that. We have come to the offering point, but I'm also going to talk to you about a couple of other things. It gives them a little break back there while they stretch their fingers or do whatever they do to get ready for the second half, which, by the way, is going to be amazing. The best is yet to come. We're going to hear from Edvard Grieg. We're going to hear from one of my very favorites. We're going to hear from John Philip Sousa. That is one of my favorite pieces, but John Williams, oh my goodness, I can't wait to hear the John Williams piece. So, stick around. It's going to get even better than it's already been. But let me mention, before we take the offering, a couple of things that are in your program. First of all, we have a cruise that is coming up October 8th through 15th of 2023. It's right here beside the Brent Vernon and Vision page, and so check that out. Legacy Quartet that sang at the Gospel Celebration the other night will be on that cruise, and it's going to be really exciting. It's going up into the New England area. It leaves from New York City, and it is just going to be fascinating. It's going to go clear up to Newport, Rhode Island, Portland, Maine, Bar Harbor, Maine, St. John, New Brunswick, Halifax, Nova Scotia. It's just going to be amazing. So you want to check that out. And then also, right before the very back page, you have an advertisement for our Holy Land trip. How many of you have ever been to Israel? Oh, quite a few of you. How many of you who've been to Israel would like to go back sometime? I have never met anybody who went to Israel who didn't want to go back. And I would love for you to go. I happen to be leading that tour. President Malloy is going to be going with us. And by the way, I'm going to ask him if he would come and pray for us in just a moment over this offering. You all need to get to know President Malloy if you haven't already. He is our new president here at Hope Sound Bible College, Hope Sound Christian Academy. He's doing a fabulous job. He'll be with us on the tour, and we also have Dr. Paul Kaufman. Dr. Paul Kaufman is our chairman of Bible and Theology here at the college. He knows Hebrew. He attended the Hebrew University, which was a part of Johns Hopkins University, and at the time he was the only Gentile student in the student body. That was quite a badge of honor, he said, in those days. He said he was sort of a celebrity. They would come and bounce ideas off of him and so on. Just a really neat background he has for this Israel trip. And so, I would love for you to be able to go. It is March 14 through 24 of 2024. So it's just about 1 year from now, which gives you a little bit of time. We don't have our price quote yet. By the end of this month, we'll receive a price quote from the airlines, but it's going to be somewhere in the range of $3,500 to $4,000 per person. That's all inclusive. That's your flight from Miami to Israel. That's your hotels, two meals a day, your guide, your entrance fees, your bus in Israel, all of that. We've done about 10 tours to Israel over the years, and so we have some experience and have some wonderful connections in Israel, and you will love this trip. I will say, hurry. If you want to go, make haste, as Jesus said to Zacchaeus, and get your name on the list, because I am getting inquiries every day. Something about COVID made people want to travel. People got cooped up, and now they're dying to use their passport again, right? I just used mine a couple of weeks ago for the first time in about 3 years. So we would love to have you go, but you better get your name on the list. Space is limited. So see me after this event if you would like to inquire about that. We'd love to have you go. All right. We've talked about sponsors, but I say it every time. Who is the number one sponsor of this series and these concerts? You are. That's right. These are free will offering. Now, let me explain to you something about the offering tonight. I don't get paid to do what I do. We pay just a minimal stipend for the sound man and the tech crew back there. And by the way, give them a big round of applause, Justin Ellison. We're going to pay a small stipend to Brandon Mills and his group of guys who moved these massive, heavy pianos. Give them a big round of applause. And of course, we're going to pay Dr. Paul Peek for tuning all of these pianos. He is the founder of this concert series. This Piano Extravaganza was his brainchild many years ago, as was the Singing Christmas Tree and so on. He's going to show up on the very last piece. He's going to play the Stars and Stripes Forever. So make sure you give Dr. Peek a big high five for getting all of this started. But we'll pay him a little bit for tuning these pianos. But here's the thing. This is what I want to get across to you. You are the ones who get to decide how much these hardworking performers are going to get. They've been working since May. So far, they haven't made a dime. You are the ones who will decide. Once those expenses are paid, we will divide the money that comes in up amongst the pianists according to the number of pieces that they play. All right? So, why don't you be real generous, dig deep, and just put a nice big offering in the cups tonight. I'm going to ask those ushers to come forward. I'm going to ask President Malloy. He would come and pray at this time. And dig deep and make sure you reward these pianists for their very, very hard work. God bless you.
Heavenly Father, we want to thank you this evening for, Lord, every good and perfect gift that comes from above. We're grateful for the gifts that have been on display to us this evening in the form of talents. We thank you, Lord, for those who have performed this evening for your honor and glory. We're so grateful for so many of our friends that have joined us for this beautiful evening. Now we ask, Lord, that you would bless this offering. Lord, may your kingdom be advanced through it all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
about all of these fabulous pianists? Let me just mention very quickly, once again, a big thank you to Dr. Paul Peake, whose brainchild both the concert series and the Piano Extravaganza was many years ago. Give it up for white-haired Dr. Peake down there. And then, most important of all, we want to thank Mrs. Mary Ann Mills for the many, many hours. Take a bow. The many hours. Why don't you all take one more bow here tonight? Give them one more round. Okay, God bless you all. Tell your friends, visit the bookstore, and have a wonderful evening.